I'm going to show you a way to make kind of a base model that you can work with on this ring here. This way, probably many ways to do it. It's just one way I do it. So let's start off with let's make the finger size. For right now, I'm just going to use a finger size of 20. I'm going to make part of the shank to begin with, so right here at the quad, I think I want to make it 2.25 millimeters line. And I'm going to do one on this side too, 2.25. And down at the bottom, I think I'll make it about 1.35. Now I'm going to draw an arc here from the ends, from the end, and to the end snap there. I'm probably just going to make the model in 1/4 because it's symmetrical and mirror things around, but we'll just do it this way for right now. Now, what I'd like to do is we're going to draw the emerald cut pattern there, shape. And I think you can do whatever you want. This is your design. Let's see. But we'll just go with it. We'll go with it right there for right now. I'm going to just chamfer this. And let's see, I got like a 2.25, I think. That's too much. Let's go with up here. Let's just try it 2. And too much down. Let's just try a 1. And enough. We'll go 1.5. That's the area. You can tell it's not a scripted tutorial, okay? But we'll do that for right now. And what I want to do is I want to join all these together. First of all, I want to join them. And let's see. Let's join these. I have a reason for this. And it says want open curve. Let's see. Okay, we got open curve at 5. Let's copy this. Copy in place. And I'm going to move it straight up my front viewport. I'll take it up about. Go like there, 2.5 on this one. Maybe a little bit higher. And then I'm going to just lock it. So what we want to do is finish up the shank now. And what I'm going to do also, I'm going to just draw a line. I want to split that bottom. I'm going to unlock this right now, and I'm going to just hide it so it's not in a visual. I want to split this bottom one. So we'll split it out. Get out of there. Now I've got to split this and this. And get rid of that. Now we should have 2. There we go. I think I'll just cut that. Keep it out of our way right now, and I think I'll just see if I can split this up. Here we trim it. Okay, so now we're just working with this right here. Let's define our width, and I'll draw a line from our shank, as you can see right down here. And I'll have my ortho on, and we'll make it about 2.75. 2.75. There, we got that. Now what I want to do, I'll draw a line and connect this from here, and we'll go to connect it there. And I'll take my line, I will change the degree to a degree 3, and turn on my points. I'm going to take these three and points, and I'm going to come to the move, select this one right there, and I'll be looking in the top viewport just so you can see this. I'm going to set the points to the I think the X plane. So I'll check these off. Okay. And that is not what I wanted, so it's going to go to the Y plane. Now you can see these points are all lined up, and you can tweak them or however you want to do it, but for right now we'll just leave it like that. Okay, and I think I'm going to take those curves. Let's explode this for a second. Yeah, I'll take these curves. That one, this one, this one, and this one. And you can see here, let me just join them together. Now what I want to do is I want to bring back that hidden octagon there. And what we're going to do is we're going to come to this tool right here. And that'll be extend our curve. And I'm going to extend my curve. And I'm going to have my mid snap on and snap it to the mid. So there's our curve right there. Oops. That's our curve we just drew. Now I do want to do this for a little bit smoother surface. I'll turn my points on. And then once again, I'm going to come to this tool right here and grab these 2 points. I'm going to align them this time in the X. And I'll line them up right there. And now we have that. Turn my points off. We're ready to build. Let's come over here. We're going to extrude those curves right there. And we'll take it up to the mid and wherever we snap to. We have it that now. Now let's trim this away. Take this as our trimming tools. We're going to trim that, and we're going to trim that away. And there we have this so far. Now if you wanted, we could just go ahead and build the surface there and finish it off. But here's something that I like to do. Show you this. I'm going to explode that. Then I'm going to split this. Like this. And actually we won't be needing these pieces anymore. So we'll just get them out of our way so we're not seeing everything. And we probably won't be needing these anymore, hope so, just in case. I'll hide them. Or I might need them. Need one of them there. I'm going to explode that. Because we still need this curve right here. I'm just clearing up the house. So cleaning the house and getting some curves that we're not going to need right now. So basically, we're left with these curves. I might as well split this. Split this curve. Get that one, okay. And this one, we'll do this later. Alright, what I like to do is trick it out a little bit. I'll take this curve now, my right viewport. Let me rebuild a degree of it, first of all, to degree 3, enter, and I'll turn my points on, and I'll take it down. Now this is just optional, you do not have to do this, it's up to you. You can do it however you want to do it, because it's your design. Points off. Now I'll take this line and we're going to just extend it out. It doesn't matter. I just want to get past that center line. So we're going to make a surface and we're going to trim it away. Then let's make our surface and trim it away. Let's see how we do. We'll go with a 2 braille. Take that. Take that. Take this, and take that, okay, that's okay. Now what I will do, come into the top viewport, and we're going to trim away that section. When we extended that curve, it made our surface so longer, which is what we want to trim it away so everything lines up in the end. When we do our mirrors. So this is what we have so far. Let's join them all up, see if they're all joined. Fingers crossed. There we are. Now we're going to mirror them. Let's join those, see if fingers crossed. Yes, they join. Let's mirror it one more time. And we'll join them up. Alright. Let's take a line here. And snap on. Let's take a line from there to there. And a line from there to there. I'll go over here. We'll grab that one. We'll grab these pieces. And we'll make our surface from those pieces. And then we'll join them again. Let's join. Let me see if they join. If they don't, we'll have to fix them. Let's just see. And let's see if I can get a cap on this. Alright, this is what we have so far. Now. Okay, now what I want to do is I want to split our inside finger curve. So I want to put a point at the put at the quad. Now I'll put a point at the quad here. And then we're gonna split it. But we could trim it. We could trim it. And we'll use our points for our trimming tool. And we will trim the top half of it. Okay, we don't need that. I'm going to draw a line from with my end snap on from there to there, and I'm going to draw a line from there to there. Now we're going to do some rail sweeps, and I think I'll just do it like this so we get a, so we're going to do a 2 rail sweep. First rail, this is second round. Let me just check something. I think I need to actually make a line. I want to make my solid line there. Let me grab these. You got a curve here? No. Get that right there, and then I'm going to join it. Let's try this again. Okay. We might go about a different way. Got a 2 yard sweep. We got this one. And we got that one. Won't work. Okay, we'll try 1 yard sweep. I'm going to mess with it. I'll do them like this. Sometimes they come out even better, I find. And I can do a 2 rail sweep here. Surface edge, and then grab that. And then that. Then I do it. Okay. And if I want, I can mirror it. Let's see. I think I missed it. Oh, we'll mirror it again. Looking at perspective. I get mixed up sometimes. So we got that time. I think I got two here, so I'll get rid of the tunnel one. Nope. Okay, I'm just checking. See, I got two there. And get rid of one. Let me see. Alright. Yeah. Now we're going to go here and finish this part up. We're going with a 2 rail sweep. And up here, chain the edges. And we start to pick our edges. First edge, pick the second edge, it'll be here, 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 and here. And we'll pick the surface edge, pick OK, highlight it all up, keep your fingers crossed, go to join, and I'm going to check my no naked edges, good. So, do one other thing, and then you're on your own from here. Okay, what I want to do is grab these curves, edges right here. And again, hey, if you got a different way to do it, do these things, that's fine. It's just something that I do. Let's take this and offset that. We'll go through point. And again, do whatever you want. But let's just, I'll do it like that. Now take this curve. And I'm going to ortho on. I'm going to drag it straight up. Whatever you want to do. Now it's your ring. I'm going to draw a line from the end to the end. And you know what it's going to do. 2 rail sweep. Okay. Now we've got a situation where we could cap it, but it might not work and bullion together. Let's just see. About what? I want to cap. Will these bullion together? I don't think so. And let's see. Did it? Yes, they did. I'm going to do it. Let's just check. No naked edges. Boom. So there you have it right there. Figured I'd show that to you, how I would go about making a ring like that. And again, you can... signet ring or diamond in there or whatever. Let me show you one other thing real quick. If you want to do this, again, this is your ring. Do what you want to do. This is the thing I might do. I might come up here and I might, well, I might end up tweaking that bottom and bringing it in a little bit. See how it tapered there? You can undo it. Or I can take it up from here, which I'm going to do that too. Put flat. I'll turn my snap off. And just bring it in just a little bit. Like that. Alright. Do it what you like. Again, you can bring this up higher if you want to do this and make it higher. Alright, hope you guys, let me know what you think of that. Alright. Thanks for watching.